The one that sent me to set the captives free. I decree 2015, every captivity of your life is turned already. For somebody, your relationship captivity has turned. The issue of your marriage has already turned. The issue of your family has already turned. I decree the God of Graceland has told me to declare to you, this new year, the grace of God will accompany you. The grace of God will follow you. You will experience heaven on earth. In your finances, you will experience heaven on earth. In your going out, you will experience heaven on earth. 1,000 shall fall. 10,000 shall fall. It will not be your portion. In Jesus' precious name, in the precious name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Good morning, Facebook family. Good morning, Facebook friends. Good morning, Facebook followers. Good morning, overcomers at home and abroad. This is God's servant Simeon Eldama coming to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You are welcome to a new month. Welcome to a new day. This is the month you've long been waiting. This is the month in the midst of the year. You are welcome to our season of preparations for revival. Preparations for revival. And this morning, we are looking at heart preparation for revival. Heart preparation for revival. My Bible says, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 6. So your heart condition determines your earth condition. How prepared are you in the heart? Ezra chapter 8 and Ezra chapter 7 and verse 10. My Bible says, Ezra prepared his heart to seek the law of his God and to teach his status and ordinances and to do them. Ezra prepared his heart. So Christian friends, in order to achieve the maximum benefit out of this season, we need preparation. And our principal preparation is the state of our heart. Why are you seeking God? If you are seeking God only for your personal good, then you need to re-examine your motive. Because God will always bless us and give us the desires of our heart, but our heart must be right. Our heart should be saturated with His love. It should be saturated with His light. Our heart should be saturated with His word. Our heart should be pounding after Him. Our heart should be pounding after Him. This is why the Bible says in Ezra chapter 8 and verse number 21, that Ezra proclaimed a fast. He proclaimed a fast at the river of Ahava. Proclaim a fast that we will seek of Him the right way. The right way for ourselves, the right way for our sons, the right way for our daughters, for our spouses, and for everything that pertains to us, we need the right way. So the right way begins with the right heart. The right heart. In Proverbs chapter 23 and verse 26, He said, "My son, give me your heart." Proverbs 23:26, "Give me your heart." So God is interested in our heart. God is interested in our heart. So Ezra proclaimed a fast, but before proclaiming a fast, he prepared his heart. He prepared his heart to seek the laws of his God. He prepared his heart to seek the law of his God. Christian friends, it is proper preparation that permits proper performance. Brilliant performance comes from proper preparation. We are in the midst of the year. We are in the half of the year. This is the season, June, July. It's time to seek the law in form of fasting and prayers. We have seen 5 months successfully. And after July, we have 5 months ahead of us. But between June and July, we are in the midst of the year. According to Haggai chapter 1 from verse 1, we are in the midst of the year. According to Habakkuk chapter 3 and verse 2, we are in the midst of the year. So Christian friend, what is expected of us? This is the time to do personal examination. And like David said in Psalm chapter 51 and verse 10, "Create in me a clean heart, O Lord, and renew your right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence. Take not your Holy Spirit from me." So David understood the mystery of heart preparation. He said, "If I abide iniquity in my heart, God will not hear me. God will not hear me." Christian friends, if you have people that you are holding in your heart, if you have people you are contending with in your heart, if you have malice in your heart, lay them aside. Lay them aside and check your motive. Are you seeking after God and His kingdom? Are you seeking after righteousness, which is the foundation for anything that God will ever build? And God has ever built is righteousness. Righteousness is the foundation. That's why He says, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness." And His righteousness. "Upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance, there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess her possession." So you want to build, the foundation of building is your right heart. Your right heart. A mentor said to me many years ago, I will never forget. He said, "Dunbar," I said, "Yes, sir." He said, "You know why things are working for you?" I said, "No, sir." He said, "Do you know there are many that are more qualified than you?" I said, "Yes, sir." He said, "Do you know that when you were leaving, there were many that left along with you?" I said, "Yes, sir." He said, "Do you know that after you left, others have also left?" I said, "Yes, sir." He said, "Now, but you know the secret?" I said, "No, sir." He said, "You have a good heart. Everything produces in this kingdom according to the state of your heart." And I will never forget that. So Christian friends, I never allow anything to puncture my heart. I never allow anything to disturb my heart. That's why Jesus said, "Let not your heart be troubled." Don't let fear overcharge you. Don't let anything take hold of your heart. Don't let worry and concern. Don't let worry and concern. In Matthew chapter 6 and verse number 21, Jesus said, "Where your treasure is where your heart will be." Where your investment is where your heart will be. That's why you give money when you go to church. That's why you invest in the kingdom of God. Because every time you invest in the kingdom of God, your heart will be there. Bible says, "Where your treasure is there your heart will be." So where is your heart this morning? What is the heart condition this morning? We are crying to God for revival these 10 days. We are provoking heaven and asking for divine intervention that there will be a turnaround. And whatever we declare in these days, I can assure you God will answer in the name of Jesus. There will be quick and immediate answers in the name of Jesus. Remember, heart preparation is the first kind of preparation that God respects. Prepare the state of your heart. And you cannot have a heart for God and you don't have a time for God. There's some time for God. You can have a heart for God and you will not sacrifice to God. You can have a heart for God. Proverbs chapter 4 and verse 22 says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Guard your heart with all diligence. For out of your heart are the issues of life. Issues of life come from your heart, but you need to guide your heart. Don't let anyone bring evil words to you. Don't bring anyone bring somebody's name to you. Don't let anybody castigate another person before you, and your heart is panting after evil or revenge or so on and so forth. No, my God will turn it around in the precious name of Jesus. My God will turn it around. So this morning we shall be praying. First of all, we shall be praying for a new heart. We shall be praying for a new mindset. We shall be praying that this day, if there's anything that overcharged us, anything that has made us afraid, anything that has frightened us from the beginning of the year to this time of the year, we are crossed over into a new month. We need a new heart. We need a new heart. Let God take away the stony heart and give us the heart of flesh, that His word will find place in our heart, that His word will find place, that our heart will begin to pant after Him. In Psalm 63 and verse 1, He said, my soul thirsted for you. My flesh is longing after you. My heart is panting after you. I want to see your power. I want to see your glory. I desire to see your intervention. And as we pant after God in love, as your heart is loving God and loving the things of God and the kingdom of God, please be informed, please be assured that the heart will grant you, my God will grant you the desires of your heart, because your heart is pure, your heart is right, your heart is clean for others, for God, for His kingdom. Don't be judging God this morning. Don't get angry and get angry with God this morning and say, God, why do you allow XYZ to happen? God, you are complaining and murmuring in your heart. The Bible says you are heading for destruction. Murmuring and complaining will head you into destruction. But this morning there is a turnaround. This morning there is a turnaround. A clean heart is what we need in Jesus' precious name. I said in Jesus' mighty name. So this morning we shall be praying. First of all, we shall be thanking God for this new season. Thank Him for answered prayers. Thank Him for the salvation of souls in the beginning of the year to date. Let's thank Him for His power and for His presence that has been manifested in our own life. And so, Father, we say thank you. We thank you for answered prayers. We thank you, O Lord, for your intervention, for the reopening of the Church of Jesus Christ. We thank you for the first 5 months of the year. We thank you for all the prayers we have prayed in time past that has received answers. We say thank you. We say thank you for intervening in our nation. We say thank you, Lord, for stretching out your hands to heal in our families. We say thank you this morning, in this new day and this new month. We know you have great things to do for us this month. But Lord God Almighty, we thank you for restoring your beauty, for restoring color, for restoring, oh Lord, our destiny to where it ought to be in the name of Jesus. Father, we say thank you for your healing power, for your revival in our nation and the nations of the earth. In the precious name of Jesus, in Jesus' precious name. Lord, your word says it is a good thing to give you thanks. Secondly, this morning we shall be praying and also committing into the hands of the Lord. We shall commit all our broadcasts this month into the hands of the Lord. And say, Father, we pray for a hitch-free broadcast. We pray for a hitch-free broadcast on this platform, that every time people come, oh Lord, they will hear your word. Souls will be saved. We pray nothing will hinder us. Megabytes or how you call it, the satellite or whatever condition, the network will not be a problem. We cover all our equipments with the blood of Jesus. We cover our technicians with the blood of Jesus. We cover our speakers on this platform with the blood of Jesus. We say every broadcast will be hitch-free and will be hitch-free this time and every time this year in Jesus' name. Let's begin to pray that prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for a hitch-free broadcast on this platform. We pray, oh Lord, that every time we come up to open our mouth, you will fill our mouth with divine revelation. Lord God Almighty, we pray that we will come to this platform, and on this platform, you will save souls. You will bless multitudes out there. You will strengthen the weak. Oh Lord God Almighty, you will encourage others out there. By this platform, Lord, you will win many into your kingdom. You will win many into your kingdom. Every enemy, every desire of the wicked one against this platform It will not hold. It will not hold in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for each free broadcast. We plead the blood of Jesus over this platform. And we decree and declare it. There shall be no evil report. There shall be no hindrance of any kind in the precious name of Jesus. Father, this day we commit the leadership of our nation into your hand. Lord, your word says in Proverbs chapter 21 and verse 1. That the heart of the king is in your hand. We pray that you will turn leaders unto you. You will turn our local leaders unto you. Turn our national leaders unto you. Turn, O Lord, our church leadership unto you. We pray for a major revival at the seat of government. That multitudes will be in the valley of decision and return to you. And they will give Liberia over to you. And then leaders will turn the nation over to you. Father, we pray, let the hearts of our leaders begin to pound after righteousness and godliness, O Lord. And how to please you and please the masses in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for everyone in one position of authority in this nation, everyone in the public sector, in the private sector, in the religious sector. We ask for your intervention in the name of Jesus. Lord, shine your light, shine your light, shine your light on our leaders. Let darkness not control them. Let it not be controlled by the wickedness of the wicked. Let the evil counselor assigned to them be dispossessed and dislodged in the name of Jesus. Every evil counselor assigned to mislead them, we dislodge them now in the name of Jesus, in the precious name of Jesus. And Lord, this morning, we are calling on you this day, O Lord, according to your word in Zechariah chapter 12 and verse 10. You said, God, you will pour upon your people the spirit of grace for supplication. Lord, we pray all followers, all members, all friends and all family that are watching on the internet this morning, that are connected to this platform, we pray that you pour out the spirit of grace for supplication on my nation and every nation on the earth, that people will begin to pray like never before in the name of Jesus. These 10 days, oh Lord, you will strengthen us in prayer. We will stand up in prayer, oh Lord, and we will make declarations and they will surely come to pass. We pray for the spirit of grace for supplication. Makota brikalala, leke tesuse likata labratala. Let spiritual gifts be manifest in the name of Jesus. Pour your spirit of grace. Pour out your spirit of grace for supplication in the name of Jesus. Lord, upon my household, upon my ministry, upon my family, upon my followers and my viewers, my family, pour out your spirit of grace for supplication. Even now, as we declare, oh Lord, let it stand in the name of Jesus. Pour out your spirit of grace for supplication. Pour out your spirit of grace for supplication in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we pray, let the spirit of grace and supplication inhabit the nation, control the people of this nation, leading to massive, massive salvation of souls. We pray for the spirit of grace and supplication to stand effectively and effectually in the gap. Father, we pray, as we stand in the gap, oh Lord, you will save our family, you will save our loved ones, you will save all that connects and pertains to us in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord God Almighty, this morning we declare peace. You said in Job chapter 33 and verse 34 and verse 29, when you give peace, no one can make trouble. When you give quietness, no one can make trouble. Whether it be done against a nation or against a person. Father, you will pray this day for peace in the nation of Liberia. We pray for peace in the continent of Africa. We pray for peace in the United States of America. We pray for peace in the European nations. Father, we pray that this day multitude will seek after Jesus, because Jesus Christ is the Prince of Peace. Father, we pray that the tension building up because of racial segregation, we pray this day, oh Lord, for racial profiling. We ask, oh Lord, that demonic action of policemen and brutal action of policemen, Lord God Almighty, we pray for a turnaround. We pray for a turnaround. Let your peace reign in New York City. Let your peace reign in Minneapolis. Let your peace reign in California. Let your peace reign in Carolinas. Let your peace reign all over the United States, in Texas, in Austin, in Houston. Let your peace reign. Let your peace reign in Toronto. Let your peace reign in London, England. Let your peace peace reign in Liberia. Let the peace reign in Monrovia, Liberia, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray against violence of every kind. We pray against the destruction of lives and property. Lord God Almighty, we pray, let justice be done. Let justice be done. Your word says that teeth for a teeth, eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth. Lord God Almighty, he that takes man's life, let his life be taken by man. Lord God Almighty, we pray, let justice prevail. Let justice prevail, irrespective of our king's color, our skin color. Lord, you made one race, and that is the human race. We pray for a reorientation. Lord, we pray that a revival will spark up. A revival will spark up, that white men will forgive black men. Black men will forgive white men. And Lord God Almighty will live together on this planet Earth as one people with one blood. One people with one blood, in the name of Jesus. Lord, let your mercy prevail. Let your mercy prevail. Oh Lord, on the justice system, we pray for justice to prevail. Let justice, let light shine in the justice system, in the court system. We pray against bribery and corruption. We pray against bribery and corruption. We pray against nepotism this morning. We pray against tribalism, sectionalism. We pray against every maneuver in the background of wicked politicians. Lord God Almighty, we pray in everywhere that laws have been created that are causing chaos among the people, let it be changed. Let it be changed. Let it be changed. In the name of Jesus. Father, this day we will not end this broadcast without praying for a new heart. A new heart, O Lord. We pray that you create me a clean heart. Renew your right spirit for all followers this morning. For all watching this morning, for all connected this morning, this fast and prayer will lead to a new beginning. Father, that runaway husband, let him return home. The runaway wife, let her return home. Lord God Almighty, we pray that sick child, let him return home. Let that brother on admission in the hospital be discharged this day. Everyone connected to this ministry, connected to this platform, this day stretch out your hand. Let the month of June be a month of divine restoration, divine healing, divine favor, in the name of Jesus. All we have lost in previous month, you will restore them all. Restore them all. Restore them all. When the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Our mouths were filled with laughter. Our tongues were singing. Then said they among the heathen, the Lord had done great things. Lord, do great things. Turn again our captivity. Do great things. Turn again our captivity. Turn our economy. Turn our families around in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for your intervention. Let this month be the month of answers. For that daughter of yours, let this month be the month of answer. For that son of yours, let this month be the month of answers, in the name of Jesus. Lord, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end. Makota brika lekete suze likata labayaba yaba manto pralika talabayaba. You will contend with them that contend with us and save our children. We cover our children with the precious blood of Jesus. We cover our investment with the precious blood of Jesus. We cover all our family members with the precious blood of Jesus. We cover our ministers of the gospel with the precious blood of Jesus. Enough is enough. Makota brika lekete suze. We decree and declare an end to COVID-19. As we begin a new month, we begin the recovery process. We decree an end to COVID-19 in Liberia. We decree an end to COVID-19 on the west coast of Africa. We declare an end to the COVID-19 on the continent of Africa. We declare an end to COVID-19 in every nation of the world, in the name of Jesus. Every agenda to perpetrate evil, every agenda to depopulate, every evil agenda to keep us as vulnerable people, we decree and declare it shall not hold in the name of Jesus. It shall not hold in the name of Jesus. Lord God Almighty, you will say, woe unto him that decree unrighteous decree. We commit our upper house of parliament and our lower houses of parliament. We ask, O Lord, that they will not make declarations that will be evil against the people of this land. Lord God Almighty, we decree this day, whatever meetings they must have had, whatever they have conspired to do in darkness, let it come to light. Let it come to light. Let it come to light. Let it come to light, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that your church in this nation will be salt and light. Your church will stand up for what is right. Your church will have a voice in the land, and the leaders will listen to the church, and the people will be willing. Lord, pour out your spirit of revival.
pour out your spirit of revival. Revive us, O Lord God Almighty. We desire your hands. Stretch out your hands. We prepare our hearts to seek you, O Lord. Let there be answers in this season. Let there be quick answers in this season. And let your name alone be glorified. Take all the glory, Lord. Revive this work in the midst of the year. As we continue these 10 days, Lord, we know there will be testimonies, unusual testimony for our partners, unusual testimony for our kingdom laborers, unusual testimony for those who have made it their business to invest in what you are doing on this platform. Lord, let them have their instant testimony. Let there be testimony now. Testimonies of salvation. Let people from another religion cross over to Jesus. Let multitude cross over to Jesus. Let children that are named the name of God depart from iniquity. And let there be a massive movement into your house. Father, we pray that your house will be filled in this season. Your house will be filled in this season. The nations will come unto us, unto you, O Lord. The nations will come unto you, O Lord. We compel them to come in the name of Jesus. Worry and anxiety, loose your hold this morning in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for it is done according to your will. It is done. Father, we say thank you for the faithful followers and the viewers, and thank you for those that are connected and believe in what is happening on this platform. Lord, let this month be the month of turnaround. Let this month be the month of turnaround. Let that daughter appointed for destruction, let that evil appointment be disappointed this day in the name of Jesus. Let this son and that daughter return with rejoicing unto Zion. They must return with rejoicing unto Zion. We must all return with rejoicing unto Zion in Jesus' precious name. Amen. God bless you and God bless you. See you again at the midnight hour of prayer. Remember, in this time of fast and prayer, our centers are open. Our churches are open for noonday prayers. Our churches are open for 6 p.m. prayers. Okay, please pray at home if you're in the nation of Liberia. But there will be noonday prayers. There will be 6 p.m. prayer. And there will be 12 midnight prayers. Expect to see us online. God bless you and God bless you in Jesus' precious name. Amen.